Okay, here we are again. Thank you, viewers. We will be starting into the next game. This is still Cadet Cup, of course, day one, and we will be seeing Rogue Squadron Hydro versus 612 Valor Squadron. This time I will have it easier to assign factions here because those Valor guys, well, as you can see, they don't have the most thrilling names, but it makes it easy to assign factions, and I will assign them New Republic for match number one here. Okay, I've learned a lot already during my very short career as caster here. I know the first match will be on the first map will be randomly selected, so we only learn which map it will be after I press the button to start the actual game. However, I should not forget to choose that specific map for the rematch for this game number two. Let's check with the teams if they are ready. I think they are, because it was, again, apologies, me who was slow here. Teams ready? Question mark. Rogue Squadron Hydro is ready. Waiting for Valor to confirm. Bup. Valor is also ready, which means I think we can start right into the game soon. Okay, let's do it then. Here we go. And the map. Did it say Gallatin there again? Did it just say Gallatin there again? It said Gallatin there again. Okay, you all saw it. It was random, right? I did not choose Gallatin. It was set at random before. It's not my fault, but now, I mean, Rogue Squadron Hydro will probably be in some kind of advantage here, won't they? Because they know this map. They've played here before. They know every rock. They've crashed into every rock. Oh, there it says examine ships now. Button number 7. And here we go. We have, this is interesting, Teo Garrett going with the support ship here this time. Targeting beacons and iron missile. We have Mick Menanti with a TIE bomber. Standard farming loadout. Oh, and they... Was that really a minute? Time flies when you're having fun. I didn't have a chance to check all the loadouts, or probably they marked themselves ready and did not give me the full minute I would have needed here to, of course, go into all of the games, all of the loadouts. It is rather stressful casting, by the way. You should try it. Okay, what I could already see there is that Rogue Squadron Hydro apparently changed their roster a bit. They have more than those three players we saw in the last game on their roster. And it seems they've done some changes. I'm still hoping we will see Marco back in that A-Wing in the next match. Okay. And here we are, flying in for 612 Valor Squadron. For the New Republic is Valor 7, Valor 5, and Valor 1. This makes it easy for me. Valor 7 in a Y-Wing with standard farming loadout. Valor 5 in what seems to be an iron loadout. I think it's an iron torpedo and concussion missiles. Interesting. And Valor 1 in another bomber with farming loadout. Fiora DVD is flying a TIE Defender here. Iron Missile, Concussion Missiles. We already see Iron Missiles flying there. Mick Menanti is going to farm again. And let's see what Teo Garrett is doing with that targeting beacons and Iron Missiles of his. He is using standard lasers, which is interesting. But Iron Missiles there. Okay, let's see what we can do with that loadout. Morale still looking pretty even here. there goes the iron missile, and Vala chaffed it, even though it was a pretty good dunk. He probably pre-chaffed it. He knew that Teo Garrett was there after him. Vala 7, meanwhile, is farming there quite a long distance away of that TIE fighters. Vala 5 gets iced here by Teo Garrett, I think, by the support. Out of shields here, he is in a very difficult position. He has Teo Garrett right on his backside. Let's see if someone will go down. As far as I'm concerned, I didn't miss any kills here, but now we see Vala 5 go down, being chased by that relentless support ship, as it seems. That's really great fun seeing support take such an active role in the PK action here. Now players are marked again. Marks went out. I'm not sure they hit, though. This is another problem with Gallatin, that those targeting beacons, they hit the rocks too and get intercepted by it. There's not a lot which that can stop those marks, but those rocks actually can. And which means Vala 7 was perfectly able to chaff the first of the iron missiles coming for him, but not the second one here. And Teo Garrett is at it still. Another iron missile. Oh dear, oh dear. But now he got too close. I think he got into the danger zone. Oh, that is a pity. And things are looking pretty well here for Vala Squadron now. Let's see. Can they get another player kill? Will they finish it off with farming entirely? Iced again. Vala 5 is iced, but managed to get that kill on Mick Menanti. And this means New Republic is going into this first offense of this match with three people, while Empire side Rogue Squadron Hydro is down a player at the moment. Vala 5 now going for that first cruiser. He picked himself for this first attack. Ooh, there's a rock in between. That will make the torpedo lock very difficult, and he has the iron torpedo. He's too close. He messed it up. That's the problem. The iron torpedo has a minimum fire distance. It takes quite a long time to lock, and this means you have to stop here, basically. Now he got it off. Oh, I'm so relieved. He got it off. Will it hit, though? Yes, it hit. This means Delta's cruiser has lost shields. The attack can commence, and is this Raider side or is it not Raider side? Let's check on the map. This is Raider side. They decided to go for the same side the Corvette is going, making that attack a bit easier, a bit quicker, but also with the inherent risk that there might be the inadvertent kill when you might like to save the cruiser for the outer phase. But let's first get there. Morale is still looking very good for Vala here. And Delta's cruiser already at 33% hull there. What are the Empire players doing here? What is going on? Fiore trying to track down Vala 7, but the rocks got in the way of that plan. Mike Menanti is farming, and he should, because that's what will bring the morale here. If they can't get some player kills here, and we haven't seen them do many player kills so far, this means the farm will probably be once more the decisive factor, as it so often is in fleet battles. Rotary goes brrr again, as we like to see it, but what is the support? What is Teo Garrett doing here? Teo Garrett is on Vala 5. He is icing him again. Can he get the kill? Can he secure the kill? That's always the problem. The iron missile hits when you're not straight after someone. You have to get into the firing position, but Vala 5 is running here. He is looking very weak indeed, and Teo Garrett shoots another iron missile at him. Will that one hit as well? Yes, he's iced again, but also those damn rocks, right? But he gets the kill eventually, and Vala 5 goes down there. In the meantime, Delta's cruiser has been completely obliterated, and Charlie is not looking well. There he is. The Star Destroyer is free for the taking by Vala Squadron, who will now, of course, start going straight for it. Commence the attack, Vala 5 says, and well, he is quite a way away from that Star Destroyer. Let's see how the Y-Wings do with those shield generators. Corvette is now finally destroyed. Took them long enough to get that Corvette down. But now they only need one player kill or a couple of AI, and then they will have survived this first devastating attack put forth by a 612 Valor Squadron here. And Valor 1 getting ironed here. Hull is low, hull is very low, shields are completely gone, and there goes Valor 1, and there also goes that first attack. What will Rogue Squadron Hydro do now? Will they recover from that devastating attack? They need to go in now very quickly if they want to make a difference here in this game. Let's fly in with Teo Garrett. He has the targeting beacon. He has the iron missile. There goes the targeting beacon. But where is the iron missile? We need to follow this up. Oh, there goes the iron missile. Charlie's shields are getting weaker. Will Fiore also carrying that iron missile follow it up? Yes, he will. And there it goes. Damage is brought on here. Very nice. Shields are low. Shields are down on Charlie's cruisers. Let's get damage in, says Mick Menanti. Going for it. Flying under the Nebulon now. Was he trying to get some Golos off, trying to strip some turrets here? He's flying around. Come on, turn around. Shunt that rotary up and brrr, get the Nebulon, get it down here. We want to see it burn. We want to see it in crisps. Ooh, getting very close to that rock there. He is under fire. Oh, he will go down. He will go down. But Charlie's cruiser is looking precarious indeed. Only 27 hull here. However, the morale is also devastating, and they didn't get it quite out of phaseable here. That is really a pity. They couldn't just get the damage in. Boom, says Fiora DVD in the TIE Defender, and is down. Oh, now it's only Teo Garrett left here. What will the others do? Valor 7 getting some resupplies by that perfectly healthy frigate of his. Shields even still up. But the Star Destroyer has still all of its subsystems. They had half an attack phase and really couldn't get a lot of damage in. Valor 7 now heading for that Vandersloop angle, going for the shield generator. It is at 70, it is at 50, it is at 30, and it is 20, 10. It stays, will it go? It goes down. Okay, one shield down, one more to go there, but so is Valor 7. 1% hull. This will need some serious shield skipping, but he's bringing it all in here. He goes all in, he risks his own life. Valor 5 in the meantime. Whoa, this is a bumpy ride here. I'm very happy we're in this cockpit to see this. Also at 1% hull, what have they done that they can survive these bumps with 1% hull? But it is not enough to get out of there alive. Now it's on Valor 1 again. Valor 1 going for that second shield generator. Morale bar is half empty from his point of view. And he has to get another shield threat. He shot those multi-locks too early. They only hit the shields, but at the same time brought them down at least temporarily. The shields were taken down, not the shield gen as such, but Valor 1 is. He will probably recover in like 15 seconds. Valor 7 probably didn't notice that shields were down. Still going for that Vandersloop angle, while he could just go from any angle really. But now the second shield gen is destroyed. The Star Destroyer is at 60% hull. And what are the defenders doing in the meantime? Fiore seems in trouble here. What is going on? Why is Fiore in trouble? I thought all of Valor are very busy getting that Star Destroyer down. Power system goes down. This brings the hull breaches, which all give like, I'm not quite sure with these modifiers, but usually they give about 7% hull damage to destroy them each, which is a lot when you destroy all five of them. There are two iron missiles flying after Valor 5 there, but it seems, and he's not able to chef them, he's marked. Ah, they flipped the face there, they flipped the face, and now it means assault time, Charlie has to die. Delta still has some shields, but Charlie, I am very sure, will go down soon. because they need it for the morale. They can't afford saving it for a potential outer phase. There will not be another phase for them. They need to get damage down now and right now. And this is exactly what Mick Benanti is doing here. Taking down Charlie, only leaving Delta for the taking, which has its shields brought down in the meantime. And the radar, always picking the stronger of the two ships, has of course started attacking Delta here as well. And Mick Benanti goes with the rotary, brings devastating damage in there, but also has some of the Valors on him. Who is it? It is Valor. No, he doesn't have someone on him. Okay, who was it shooting him then? Vela 5 is now going for Tio Garrett here, who himself is heading to bring some damage on the remaining frigate, which goes down. That Nebulon is down now. And the attack on the MC-75 has begun once more. But not for Tio Garrett, I think. Nope. Nope, not for him. He is down. He is down. But what are his teammates doing? Ooh. Okay. Fiora DVD now in a TIE fighter, which is interesting because we've seen her or him fly TIE Defender the whole match and also I think in the last match, and still not bringing in torpedoes but piercing torpedoes. And I get that because three piercing torpedoes take down one shield generator, and I think this is the strategy Fiora is going for here. There goes the shield generator. Diving under the shield and not doing any damage, on the other hand, probably not the smartest call. And here we see the modifiers working. Usually one of those piercing torps brings it down to 67. This time, two of them brought it not down to 33, but to 60. This means some laser damage, just some laser damage, will bring that shield gen down. Fiori, do it! Go under the shield! Get that damage in! But, okay, this was an interesting strategy. Shooting the piercing torpedo first and then going headfirst into the gen. What a pity. What a waste. But now Valor, I think, will bring this game to a quick end here. Well, not that quick, actually. We've had quite our share of fun here in this game. Diving, bumping on those rocks. Oh, and getting ice there. This is a pity. Flying so evasively and hugging the rocks and then still being brought down. But Valor 1 is lasering. Does he not see those hull breaches? Go for the hull breaches. I see the hull breach right there. Yeah, there goes the hull breach. And there goes the Star Destroyer. Below 10 now. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Will he go for the... There is that... There is that hull breach right there. Shoot it. Get the Star Destroyer. Someone else must have done it for him. There goes the Star Destroyer. 612th Valor Squadron taking game number one in this match against Rogue Squadron Hydro. Okay, let's have a quick look at the scorecard here and take a screenshot. I'm not forgetting it this time. Valor Squadron bringing the victory home for the New Republic here. Valor 7, 0 kills, 4 deaths, 29 farm. Look at those farm numbers. Here you can really say see why Valor Squadron won this game. Almost 60 AI kills between Valor 7 and Valor 1. Very good work there. While on the other hand, Mick Benanti was very lonely as a farmer there. Only 25 AI kills. And this shows once more how very important that farming is. Okay, we'll be right back with game number two here. Just give me a second to update that scoreboard, which I'm actually not quite sure how to do that best. Just a second. Okay, saving. Okay, let's see if we can edit that main and get that score updated. The image should change. Okay. There we go. Okay. So, Valor won first game as New Republic, which means Valor will be going Empire this time. Oh, did I switch back to... Yeah, save that. Okay, and we're back to main. Okay, just wanted to make sure I'm not showing you the Be Right Back screen for the rest of the match. There we go. No, this is wrong, this is wrong. I never use mouse and keyboard in Squadrons because I fly with Flight Stick and HOTAS, and it feels strange. It's theoretically, it should be easy to click on New Republic, but strange things happen here. Okay, we can do this. Okay. I have to find the right channel here again. Good to go for round two? Question mark. Rogue is ready, Valor is ready, I am also ready and thrilled how this will turn out. Let's do this. Start match. Ah, no. I'm not doing that mistake again. I remembered literally at the last second. Okay, it's not random this time. It will be Gallatin. Okay, Gallatin. You see? Gallatin. Okay. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me, right? Gallatin. Okay, and this time we get a look at those... didn't it say I have to push some button to get that... loadouts? Didn't it say... forgot it again. Strange things happening here again. Yeah, options. Okay, the roster didn't change. For some reason, I can't get that... I'm not allowed to change the... hangar this time. Yeah, it is a pity, Valor. Seven agrees with me here. Okay, let's go into that game. It doesn't matter. I will tell you the loadouts after the game has commenced. And we are going in for round two between those very entertaining two teams. Rogue Squadron Hydro and 612th Valor Squadron. On what seems to be my home turf, Gallatin. Did it always take that long to load in? Who knows? Okay, here we go. There we go. And this is Rogue Squadron Hydro flying in for the New Republic. And we have Teo Garrett in a Y-Wing this time. Standard farming loadout as far as I can see. We have Mick Menanti also Y-Wing with standard farming loadout as far as I can see it. And Fiore with that Iron Missile, Concussion Missile, X-Wing here. Very good choices. That should work. Valor 1 is also in a farming bomber. Valor 5 here in a TIE fighter with Iron Missile and Concussion Missile. Pretty much the same loadout he was running on the X-Wing earlier. And we have Valor 7 also with a farming loadout on that bomber. And Empire... Ooh, morale switching back and forth here. Both teams got some morale. Let's see what the player killers are doing, because we all know how boring farming can be. But it is at the same time ever so important. And probably in many games the decisive factor. So I'm not making any fun of farmers. I can't farm for my life. But I know that having good farmers on your team is very much essential. But Valor 5 is getting into trouble here, because Theo Garrett was it, is having none of that, and is basically getting out his rotary and saying no, we're not doing it like this today. What is Fiore doing? Will Fiore be able to pressure someone? Oh, it seems Fiore is going for the Raider this time, which is a very good idea. Raider is low, and I would say the call is everyone on Raider now, because Raider will flip it. Have the others heard my call here? They haven't. McManatee hasn't. There needs to be better coordination here, but they still got the flip. I think Fiore managed to take that Raider down on his or her own. I'm still not quite sure. Apologies. Doesn't matter anyway. Okay, and now we have Rogue Squadron Hydro actually, for the first time, winning a flip here and going in to attack. And damage is coming in on Charlie. They've decided to go for Charlie here, which is opposite Raider side this time. The Raider is going for Delta. They are going for Charlie, and they are going down. That is a pity, of course. McManatee heading for the Star Destroyer. That they might... might be a bit ahead of himself there. I would suggest taking down Charlie first. What is Fiore doing? We need those iron damage. We need the iron damage. Where is the iron damage? Fiore, give us some iron damage. No, not like that. Not head first again. Please don't do that. But the iron missile is still on cooldown. And again, we seem... there seems to be some miscommunication. Have they switched to Delta now? It seems they have switched to Delta now. I thought they had started working on Charlie, because shields were coming down on Charlie, but they apparently have now chosen to go for Raider side after all, taking the extra damage brought in from the Raider to get extra damage to hopefully get these cruisers out of phaseable. Nice work, nice flying we're seeing here from Fiora. What are the teammates doing? Okay, McManatee apparently had gone down, not in the danger zone yet. Fiore still trying to get some damage in, but no, going down there in the danger zone. That is a pity. McManatee, on the other hand, is picking up the farming immediately. Valor 5 getting a resupply. Valor 1 getting a resupply. Valor 7 following the Raider in, not getting a resupply. Yes, also getting a resupply. Let's see what Valor 5 will do. He had the Iron Torpedo, which went down and totally stripped Delta's shield very, very quickly. How to best strip shields is still controversial. The Iron Torpedo has the great advantage of taking them down in one go. With the disadvantage, you can only carry one of them, and they have that minimum fire distance. So if you have, on the regular fleet battles where you have 5 versus 5, if you have two people carrying iron missiles, many teams rely on those iron missiles to get shields down very quickly. But now you can see what a coordinated team Valor is. Delta already at 8%, and the Raider will probably finish it off whether they like it or not. Now, as I mentioned, the problem is Valor 5 did not get a resupply for that iron torpedo, and for that reason can't get shields down on Charlie as quickly as they probably would like. And now that Delta has gone down, their phase has extended. On the other hand, they did not... they will not have the opportunity to get that 15 morale from out of phasing any frigate there. Valor 1 going in with a rotary. The shields have meanwhile come down on Charlie after all. But both Valor 7 and Valor 5 are at low health there. But not as low as Valor 1. What happened there? What are the others doing, by the way? Fiore is, aha, on some bomber. On Valor 7, to be more exact. Chasing him. But Valor 7 is flying very evasively here indeed. And we all know what a pain it is to kill a TIE bomber. That reinforced hull just won't crack. McMananty, meanwhile, farming. I think got a little bit distracted there, even trying to assist Fiora on that player kill with to no effect. But they have flipped it now, and they have really seen how much damage Valor got in. They lost the flip, but they have more than made up for it now. Valor 5 is already on the Corvette. He got a resupply in the meantime. There goes the Ion Torpedo again, stripping those shields off of the Corvette totally, which is now one for the taking for Valor Squadron if they decide to focus their efforts and just go for it. But now Valor 5 going for McMananty. No, he's 1.5 kilometers away. You can't get him on that distance. You need to get closer. And there, now he is at firing distance. McMananty in the meantime trying to get the remaining cruiser from this time, from this view, it's not Charlie and Delta. The remaining cruiser getting damage in, flying very straight, very slow there, which, as you will soon learn, is not the best idea, even though Valor 5 also seems whipped to move back and forth there a bit. There goes the Corvette, brought down by Valor. Valor 1 is farming. Fiore desperately trying to get more damage in. But that is the problem. They don't have any proton torpedoes. They only have the concussion missiles doing thousands of damage. They have the Goliath and the multi-locks, but they have mainly to rely on their lasers, and they are not using them to the best effect either. Which means Fiora is in a difficult position, will go down here shortly, and there he goes. Sorry, I don't know why I keep saying that. My bad. But they are desperate to get it now. Okay, it's an 8. It can be out of phase. If turrets are stripped, it's not the best idea to sit right on top of it. But McMananty is really hammering it here, and he wants it to go down, and it does go down. They got those 15 morale you get for out of phasing that cruiser. Still, 612 Valor will pull past them again. Okay, this is boring. He's going back to his own hangar. Also, well, you can't win, and this is not how it works. Don't go back to your hangar very slowly. You have to attack very quickly, which is probably what Valor 5 will be doing here now. Okay, coming in. Probably letting the radar take it down entirely, because who else is shooting at it? 2, 1, go! It goes, and now the attack on the MC-75 is beginning. It seems Valor 5 is setting up a power dunk here. From the right angle, you can boost under the shields and go straight for the power system with an ion torpedo taking it down immediately, which is always very, very helpful indeed. There the torpedo goes, and it hit. Power system is destroyed. That is very good. This makes the hull breaches pop up. On the other hand, you still need to take those shields down if you don't want to sit under the shields and let the rotary do its magic. No, Valor 7. The targeting system is not that important, but shields seem to have been brought down. And indeed, we missed it, they managed to get all the subsystems down. Very strong performance indeed. All subsystems down on the MC-75. That took them no time at all. Apparently one bomber took down one each. Very good work here. And now, of course, the MC-75 is in a very precarious position. It is at 25. The phase has flipped. There is the danger zone. They will probably not go for an out of phase here. They will probably choose the more safe route to defend the Star Destroyer against Rogue Squadron. Hydro coming in now with Teo Garrett. And it seems we have some oomph this time. I see two proton torpedoes, two piercing torpedoes. One proton torpedo and one piercing torpedo shot from the right angle under the shields can, of course, bring down a shield generator momentarily. We call it the Vandesloop. And okay, this is more the fly angle, but still, will it work? Shoot those torpedoes! He shot them, didn't he? We didn't see it, but we didn't see the torpedoes. But Either way, they didn't hit, which of course is the big problem with these torpedo attacks. They can be very effective, but as torpedoes go, they can also be chaffed. They can hit the shields when they're shot at the wrong second, but they have one shield generator down nonetheless already. What is McManty doing in the meantime? Also, of course, going for that shield gen. Rotary goes brrr, and there goes the left shield gen. That is a good attack. This is the best attack we've seen from Rogue Squadron Hydro today so far, at least as far as I am concerned, but it doesn't help. Still, McManty goes down here, and it will be on Fiori, now heading straight for the power system. They, of course, know they have to kill that power system if they want to have any chance. But the phase has flipped, and I think, I don't want to sound boring, but there is a very strong chance this means game over. Because last time we saw it, the MC-75 was at only 30% hull, and even though Valor 7 is more bumping in the general direction of the MC-75, you're then really going straight for it. Of course, going straight for it is also a terrible idea. We will see the MC-75 going down very shortly. It is at 11%. Valor 5 doing damage here. It is at 9%. Are there any hull breaches left? Oh, Valor 5 getting iced here in the last second, but we see Valor 1 getting the MC-75 down with his rotary, and Valor Squadron takes game number 2 in this wonderful and very fun game. Congratulations to both teams. That was great fun to watch, and I think it's safe to say that we've seen Rogue Squadron Hydro's strongest game here so far, and it really is a pity it still wasn't enough to defeat Valor Squadron here with a very strong performance. Oh, but look at that farm. I'm not saying they took my advice to heart here in any way, but look at that farm by McManty and Teo Garrett. That is very good indeed. That is probably the explanation why Rogue Squadron Hydro was doing so well in this game this time. Kudos to both teams. I had a great time casting this, and, well, we'll see each other in the next game, I think.